Even those who compete on the world's biggest stages sometimes come from humble origins. This is the Niigata Prefecture in Japan, a place where hard work, determination, and trustworthiness are a way of life, and craftsmanship is a tradition. This is the home of Yonex. Niigata is where founder Minoru Yoneyama rose to the challenge, where he chose to take Yonex far beyond ordinary, and where the rackets and strings of some of the world's best athletes are crafted. Returning home after the Second World War, Yoneyama used an industrial motor his mother had saved for him to start his future business ventures. At first, he used the motor for producing wooden fishing floats, but the market soon changed to favoring those made of plastic. From then on, he vowed to always be at the forefront of innovation and switched his focus to the fast-growing sport of badminton. Yoneyama began crafting rackets and fine-quality shuttlecocks. Venturing into the sport of tennis in 1969 saw the company introduce the T7000 racket. Continuing Yoneyama's vow of innovation, just 1 year later, the oval press shaft beam design was introduced, greatly improving both racket strength and durability. Today, Yonex are known for the distinctive isometric head shape of their rackets. First introduced in 1980, the racket offered a bigger sweet spot and immediately found fans at the pro level. Minoru's customer focus was the soul of his work, and this focus is the inspiration which drives Yonex forward. Minoru Yoneyama passed away in 2019, and his son Ben Yoneyama continues his vision.
What I remember about my father is if his customers are not happy, when he came home, he was not happy. He has tendency to go to right if everybody goes to left. So he's very unique. So the racket, everybody makes the round, he makes the square racket. By looking at all the industry nowadays in badminton and tennis manufacturing, Yonex is very unique that we always make our own product. The reason is, even though the cost is more, but he wants to make sure the rackets he makes is best suitable for the customers.
Minoru believed in the opportunity to develop further, to forge new ideas, and it's something you can see in all of Yonex's products. It's amazing to think it all began with one motor. We were joined by Ben Yoneyama's son, Casey, and he took us to where it all began.
Casey, you're in Tsukayama. This is a really important place in the story of Yonex. Why don't you tell us why?
Tsukayama is where my grandfather was born. Tsukayama specifically is in the countryside of Niigata, and it's where our head factories are for Yonex. The reason why our factory headquarters are here is because the founder was born and raised in this very town. He was quite adamant to make sure that the factory stayed here throughout his entire career because he trusted his people, his community, and his neighborhood to make the best product. With snow like this, you need to persevere. And it gives a lot of people here character, and that character translates directly into the quality of our products.
Manufacturing of many Yonex products remains in the Niigata Prefecture to ensure its continued quality and customer focus. The rugged coastline and sometimes harsh environment of the region lends itself to a community of perseverance and trustworthiness. Japan is a country known for its craftsmanship, and this area is held in the highest regard.
We are at a sake factory or distillery, and we're going to go and see the craftsmanship.
The human touch of crafting a product brings the skill, sense, and touch of the individual and blends it with the vision of the whole. Even the creation of everyday items can be elevated through craftsmanship. It's what the Japanese call monozukuri.
Thank you. ヨネックス新潟工場の技術開発総括をやってます岩野美幸と言います。入社してから28年になります。ここが創業の地というのもありますが、やはりまず新潟、日本の中でも新潟という新潟の県人というのは非常にものづくりに対する考え方が良くて丁寧な仕事をする場所だと思ってます。
我々ヨネックスはものづくりの会社です。で、ものを作るということはもののことをよく知っていないといけないということになってきます。ものが作れない会社はやはり、お客様に、どういうものが受け入れられてどういう評価をいただいたものを製品にこうフィードバックしていくかということができない会社になってしまうと思っているので、我々ヨネックスは自社工場を持ってものを作ることができることがとても重要だと考えています。
例えばテニスラケットでもテニスのプレースタイルってどんどん変わってますので、その時代に合わせた、先を見据えたっていうところで、素材であったり、その形状であったりっていうところは、常に、進化させるよっていうのを心がけています。
やっぱり同じことをやっていたら価値は下がってると思うので、新製品に対しては常に新しいものを入れていかなければダメだと思っています。そういう意味では必ず新しいものを入れるというのが新製品だと思います。
Minoru's vow to never be left behind by technology is echoed among Yonex employees. In order to achieve continued perfection over time, Yonex innovates for the future, finding the balance between automation and human touch.
機械でやるところと、人っていうところはやっぱり、最後の検査であったりマークであったり、人でしかできない、特有のところは、人でやるっていうところと、また、人とそのオートメーションっていうか機械のところの融合で、うまいものをいいものを作っていくっていうところを意識してやっています。
人の手でやらなくていいものは人の手で やりたくないです。それはみんなコストになりますので、その中にはどうしても人の手でやらないとまだできない作業と、自分の中ではその人の手でやってほしい作業、例えば性能を決めていくような機材、材料をセットするようなものは機械ではなくて人が一つ一つ確認しながらセットしていってもらいたいということで、そこは機械化できようが人でやっていきたいところっていう、
お客さんが安心して、使ってもらえる点なんですけれども、ヨネックスは、新潟の、工場でメイドインジャパンで、作ってます。人の手と、自動化も含めて作ってますけれども、より重量もですね、しっかりと、例えば 300g であれば、ほぼ 300g の、ラケットをしっかり提供してあげる、使っても簡単に折れないような、強度も、保っている。
Yonex's manufacturing process continues to be perfected. They utilize roughly 50 inspection points to ensure that each racket is made exactly to spec. At Tennis Warehouse, we measure many examples of every new racket to check specifications, and Yonex are known as a brand with the tightest and most consistent spec tolerances.
ラケットの品質管理は約50の検査項目があります。それは各工程において誰がどういう器具を使ってどのような検査をするか、あとどういう記録を残すかということが全て決められています。でその中で当然ものづくりですので交差はあるんですが、やっぱり交差の中でバラ動きがあってはいいもの作れませんので、一個一個でできるだけ中央を常に目指していくという製造工程を行っています。
やっぱりそれは品質へのこだわり、やはり日本で作る 特に新潟で作るという製品はどのラケットを作り上げても精密なお客さんに違いがほとんどわからないというか、お客さんの重かったり 軽すぎたりっていうような、ね、均一性というものが保てられている。これが日本メイドインジャパンの誇りだと思っています。
社訓でもある通りで世界に貢献するためという、これ会社にとってその世界に貢献できるものがものづくりだと思っています。
We consider our employees part of our family, and it's very important for us to keep our research, development, and factories here in Niigata, not only to ensure quality, but to make sure we don't lose sight of where we came from and where we are going moving forward.